ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 6th பாசுரம். புள்ளும் சிலம்பின கான் புள்ளரையன் கோயில் வெள்ளை விழிசங்கின் பேரரவம் கேட்டிலையோ பிள்ளாய் எழுந்திராய் பேய்முலை நஞ்சுண்டு கள்ளச்சகடம் கலக்கழியக்காலோச்சி வெள்ளத்தரவில் துயிலமர்ந்த வித்தினை உள்ளத்து கொண்டு முனிவர்களும் யோகிகளும் மெல்ல எழுந்து அரியன்ற பேரரவம் உள்ளம் புகுந்து குளிந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹாவ் டிசைடட் டு ஸ்டார்ட் த பாவை நோம்பு, அண்ட் ஃபார் திஸ் பர்பஸ் தே ஹேட் அ மீட்டிங் ஆன் அ ஃபுல் மூன் நைட் and decided to proceed with the actual nombu the next morning. So at dawn the next morning, Aandaal comes to the decided destination and sees if all her friends have come. She finds that a few of them have not yet turned up. Aandaal is so affectionate and compassionate towards her mates that she does not want to leave behind a single friend for this divine experience. So she goes to the house of each of the friends who have not woken up and takes them into her fold and proceeds for this divine experience. It is said that Aandaal went to the house of 10 friends, or rather 10 types of friends, and woke them up. This waking up of friends has been depicted in the second and third scenes of the ThiruppAvai. As said before, the ThiruppAvai, which is a work of 30 verses, has been divided into 6 scenes, each scene having 5 pasurams or verses. So in the first scene, we saw the first 5 set of verses in which these girls spoke about the Pavai Nombu and its scope. And in scenes 2 and 3, Aandaal is going to her friends' houses to wake them up and take them along for this divine experience. So from today onwards, we go ahead to experience the second scene of ThiruppAvai. In the second scene of ThiruppAvai, Aandaal is waking up 5 types of friends who are relatively new to their fold, or the less experienced people in their group. So amongst them, she is going to the house of the newest friend first so that she can be comfortably woken up and taken into their fold. So in the 6th pasuram, Aandaal is proceeding to the house of the newest member of their group. As she is proceeding, she is trying to call out to the girl and tell her that there are many indications to prove that it has already dawned or that it is time for their Pavai Nombu. So by telling the girl these indications, she is trying to wake her up. So the first indication of dawn is that birds start chirping. So Aandaal is speaking about birds chirping as she begins the 6th pasuram. Pullum silambina kaan. Pull refers to bird. Silambina is the sound made by birds, the chirping sound. She's telling the Gopika, pullum silambina kaan, meaning, my dear friend, please come and see, the birds are chirping. She's not telling the friend to hear, but telling her to see. Kaan means come and see. Why is she saying that? Because if the girl is said to hear something, then it seems that she would say that maybe you people are so enthusiastic about going and proceeding with this vratam that you are making chirping noises by yourselves and trying to prove that it is dawn to me. So she doesn't want her friend to get any such doubt. So she's saying, please come out and see for yourself that the birds are chirping. Okay, why is this girl not getting up and coming? At the first place, why are some girls not yet ready to come and join these people for the vratam? The reason is not that they are lazy or they are not interested or something. The fact is that these girls are so absorbed in divine experience of Krishna that even in their sleep, they are continuously thinking about him and his holy names. And in the meeting that was held the day before, these girls were talking about the beautiful names of Krishna as Mayan, Vadamadurai, Maindan, Tuya Perunir, Yamunai Turaivan, Ayar Kulathinil, Tondrum, Anivilakku, Narayanan, Parkadalul, Payattu, Indra, Paraman. All these names we have been seeing over the five Pasurams last 5 days. And these girls have discussed these names. So, the ones who are sleeping at home are actually in contemplation of the Lord's names and His glory. So, they do not want to get out of that divine experience and come. That's the reason why they are seeming to be asleep. This girl too is in a similar state. So, when these girls outside are coming and calling out to her, saying that we are telling you indications about dawn, this girl inside is not really ready to get up. So, she's trying to counter them with some arguments. So, when these girls outside said that please come and see for yourself that the birds are chirping, the girl inside is replying saying that I don't think I have to come out to see. I know your enthusiasm to go and meet Krishna. So, you people have got up and you all are talking so busily amongst yourselves that it seems like bird chirping. So, Andal and her friends outside think that okay, fine. Let us tell her some other indication. So they proceed to tell her another indication. They say, Pullarayan koil vellai vilisangin peraravam kettilayo. Oh my dear friend, Andal says, don't you hear this big sound? Peraravam. Aravam is sound. Peraravam is big sound. Where is this big sound coming from? Vellai vilisangin peraravam. This big sound is coming from the white colored conch which is being blown inside temples. Which temples? Pullarayan Koil. Koil is temple. Pullarayan Koil is the temple which has the king of birds. Who is the king of birds? Garuda. And the temples which house Garuda are the temples of Lord Narayana. So, Lord Narayana's temples have opened, and as a mark of temple opening in the days of yore and in some temples even today, the conch is blown. And it is said that this conch that is blown is white in color because the morning conch which is blown is a depiction of sattvaguna or virtuousness which is associated with white color. So here Andal is talking about Vellai Vilisang, white colored beautiful conch which is making a big sound, and this is being blown in the temples where Garuda is reciting, proving that it is morning. This is an indication that it has dawned, and this is the time for us to go to those temples to take darshan of the Divine Lord. So why are you sleeping here? You have to get up and come. Here, an important aspect is, Andal is talking about Pullarayan, that is the king of birds, Pakshi Raja or Garuda, who is a great symbol of auspiciousness. As we had said earlier, this ThiruppAvai is an auspicious work or Mangala Prabandham. So, Andal now and then keeps on putting auspicious things in. So, here, she has mentioned about Garuda, who is a sign of auspiciousness, also called Kshemakari. Thus, she is telling the girl inside that, can't you hear the sound of these conches blowing? Why are you sleeping? Please come out. The girl inside is saying that the noise that you people have made is so much that even the temple authorities have got confused and they are feeling that probably it is time to blow the conch. So, you people have confused them apparently. So, I do not believe that it is really time to get up yet. Okay, fine. Andal thinks that this girl needs a little more severe treatment now. She's trying to tell her certain indications which the girl doesn't want to agree to. So Andal decides that let me try to give her a little bit of tension so that she realizes that we are actually speaking the truth. So next, she says a word, Peimulai Nanjundu. Pilla Yerindirai, Peimulai Nanjundu. Oh, my dear girl, you need to get up now. Pillai refers to a little girl who is very, very new to their group. And she's saying Yerindirai, meaning you have to get up now. You have to get up because getting up from your bed and coming and experiencing divinity with everybody else is actual existence. Irai, meaning exist. You have to actually start existing. You have to start living this divinity. So please come. Because you know what is happening now? Peimulai Nanjundu. You remember Putana? Peimulai refers to the demoness Putana and her milk-giving episode to baby Krishna. That day, the demoness Putana gave poisoned milk to Krishna. Nanjundu. Do you remember that? They are asking. By saying such a thing, they are trying to instigate the gopi to get up and come. Because once you talk about Putana, then the gopi becomes scared that, oh my god, is that Putana episode happening again? Why are you people talking about it? So thinking thus, they are thinking that probably this girl will get up soon and come out. So they talk about the Putana episode. This girl inside is a little scared now. She's slowly getting up from the bed. So the girls outside are feeling, okay, our formula has worked. So let us proceed further. They go ahead to say one more thing. What is that? Kallachagadam kalakkaliyakkalochi. You remember that cunning cart, Kallachagadam, Shakatasura, who came and tried to destroy Krishna. Then this girl inside is even more tense now. Oh my god, is that episode also rehappening now? What am I going to do? And thus startled, she's trying to get up from the bed. Andal is watching all this from outside and now she's feeling a little bad that, oh my god, I should not put so much tension into my friend's heart. So let me cool her down. So she proceeds to say, Vellattaravil thuilamarnda vittinai. Don't worry. That Krishna who was attacked by Putana and given poisoned milk the other day, that Krishna who was trying to be overthrown by Shakatasura is now peacefully sleeping in his beautiful banyan leaf. Vellattaravil thuilamarnda vittinai. Andal has put a very beautiful phrase in this. She's saying that the Lord is resting very beautifully in his palace. Like what you know, like how he rests on a little banyan leaf which is floating in the waters of deluge. It is said that when the world, the universe gets destroyed or rather gets assimilated into the Lord, it is only the Lord and he is surrounded by the water of the deluge. And in that water of deluge, in that flood water of deluge, Vellattaravil, the Lord is lying down on a banyan leaf. And actually, what is this banyan leaf containing? It is containing the Lord who is none but the seed of the universe. Vittu means seed. And that seed of the universe is lying down very happily, peacefully. Why is the Lord called the seed of the universe? Because he has got the universe within himself, which will manifest again when the right time comes. So that way, that day when he rests peacefully in the water of the deluge, the similar way he is resting today in his palace. So you need not worry. There is no harm that is coming to the Lord. We were just talking about how the Lord is peaceful now, though he was attacked by so many demons in the past. So we are now proceeding towards that Lord's palace. And it's very important that we proceed there because see, as we are talking to you, we are getting to see another indication that it is time to go to the Lord. Whom can we see now on the roads? We can see saints going on the roads. உள்ளத்து கொண்டு முனிவர்களும் யோகிகளும் முனிவர்கள் யோகிகள் refers to saints. முனிவர் refers to those saints who are absorbed in contemplation of the Lord. And yogis refers to those saints who are involved in doing divine service to the Lord. So all these people get up early in the morning and go on the streets singing the glory of the Lord. So these people who have this seed-like Lord in their hearts, ullattu kondu, meaning having this Lord in their hearts, these munivars and yogis are now going. And as they are going, they are singing the names of the Lord. Mellayelundu ariyendra peraravam. They have got up very carefully because in their hearts the Lord is residing. And they are aware of that. So it seems when munivars and yogis, the saints, get up, they get up very carefully so that the Lord in their hearts does not have any kind of jerk as they get up. So mellayelundu, they are getting up very slowly and they are walking now on the road singing his names aloud. Ariyendra peraravam, which is the name which is sung aloud in the morning. Hari, 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 hari. People sing the name Hari as they get up. We are supposed to say the name Hari 7 times as we get up from the bed. So Andal is teaching us this through this Pasuram. Just in the phrase that she said before, that Vellattaravil Thuilamarnda Vittinai, the Lord who is lying down in the water of deluge, reminds us of the state that we have to remember when we go to sleep. We have to remember this Lord on the banyan leaf in the water of deluge and recite Madhava, Madhava, Madhava thrice when we go to sleep. And when we get up in the morning, we have to recite Hari 7 times. So these little things that we need to follow, Andal has kept secretively in her Pasurams. And these are little but valuable learnings to us through the gracious mother Andal. So like this, we can see the saints, the munivars and yogis sing Harinama as they are going in the streets. So this shows that it is time for us also to go and join them. So let us go and join them, my dear friend. She calls out, Ullam pugundu kulindelorembavai. Please take this message into your heart and come out with a very cool mind and heart so that we can get into this divine experience together. Thus, listening to Andal and her friends, this little new girl, Pillai, is impressed and now gets up and comes and joins their team.